you know what resistance I'm using. And, you know, you have to make sure that you're writing down the weights that you use so that when we do these exercises later and we can compare notes so we know where we need to grow. Classic, classic chest exercise that works. The push-up. Gotta love the push-up. Okay, so I believe you can see me. I'm gonna show you a couple variations because I know that when I started, I could not do a push-up. I could not do one single push-up. So if you can, you know what it looks like. You keep your hands shoulder width apart, right? We're going to push our chest to the ground and push ourselves back up, right? So let's see if we can get 10 of these in. That's four, right? If you can't do this, you drop your knees to the ground, put your chest, push yourself back up. Chest to the ground, push yourself back up. It should be a controlled movement. Full control, right? If you can't do that, you guys, you can use anything. You can use a countertop, you can use a tabletop. I'm using my bench. So you just have your hands on your elevated surface. Bring your chest in, push yourself out, okay? So, 10. Give me 10 push-ups, okay? The next exercise we're gonna do is with the resistance band, we're gonna do a standing chest press. So we're gonna do this with our band in the door. The door anchor should be about chest level. Mine's a little high. That's good. Lock your door so nobody opens it up on you. You don't go flying in places, right? Okay, so for this exercise, I'm actually gonna use my heaviest band. This is my 50 pound resistance band. That looks good. Okay, so your bands are gonna be behind you. Your palms are gonna be facing towards the ground. You're going to stay in a staggered position. You have the most stability this way. And we're going to keep your bands underneath you. If you go on top, it gets all ouchy. So keep them underneath. From your chest, push straight out. Boom. One. Two. Three. We got 21. Four. Five. Six. Now listen. Keep the controlled movement back. Two. Seven. The bands are going to want to make you go boom, but you don't. You keep it controlled. Eight. That might have been nine. Let's say 10. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19, two more, 20, one more. Okay, so the next exercise we're going to do is as a fly. I use a lighter resistance band for this exercise. It's in the same door anchor. I don't know what pound, they say 18 pounds resistance. So with this exercise, you're going to take both sides in one hand. Use your elbow as a pivot, stick it into your hip, ready? My shoulder is about the height of the anchor. It's right in line with the anchor. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring our hand to the center, the midline of our body. So keep your elbow as a pivot, bring it in. That's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 10 more, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, two more, 20, last one, 21. Now we're gonna switch sides. So excuse my back for the moment. I'm just going to quickly come pop to the side, elbow into my hip as a pivot point, and my left shoulder is in line, direct line with my door anchor. I'm gonna pull it in to the midline of my body. One, two, three, four, five, six. Keep that elbow in and tight and complete controlled movement from the midline all the way back. Five more. Two more. Last one. Nice. All right. Flies. Okay. We're going to take this same exercise, arms straight out, and we're just going to push out to the front. So my arm is parallel to the door anchor. The band is an extension of my arm, and I am just pivoting my shoulder to the front. That's it. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, last one, 21. Feel that in here, eh? For the next two exercises, it'll be the last two chest exercises, and what we're gonna do is get our door anchor, and we're going to hook it to the bottom of our door. But what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna hook it underneath a hinge, because the motion is going to be an upward motion, and it's going to want to slide up your door jamb. I'm going to use, and what I advise you to use, is a lighter resistance band, because the distance that the band is going to be traveling is going to be further, and it's going to not give you enough pull to get full extension. 25, using 25s. And I'm just going to slip my door anchor underneath the hinge. So I'm gonna clip on my handles. Clippity-doo, clippity-yay. Clippity-yippity, whatever. Okay, here we go. And what we're going to do is similar to the chest press that we did here at chest height. We're doing it, same thing, underneath, palms facing down, stagger position, fists into the armpit and push straight out and up, straight out and up. Your arms are an extension of the band. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, controlled movements, 20, last one, 21, cool. All right, so our last exercise is we're gonna keep the band exactly where it is. Our palms are now just going to face up, and what we're going to do is keep that resistance where it's nice and tight, and a staggered stance. We're just gonna lift up. Palms up, elbows into the side, and we're just going to lift and down, that's it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, last one, 21. Great job. So if you have it in yet, do that once more or twice more through. Make sure that you end yourself with a nice shoulder and chest stretch. And I will catch you all on the fit side.